इतिहास की दिलचस्प कहानियों के लिए बेल आइकन दबाएं और सब्सक्राइब करें लिव हिस्ट्री इंडिया। नमस्कार, लिव हिस्ट्री इंडिया में आपका स्वागत है। मैं हूं अक्षय चव्हाण। हैदराबाद शहर का नाम लेते ही नजर आता है आपको चार मीनार। सुल्तान कुली कुतुब शाह ने बनाया हुआ यह स्मारक सदियों से हैदराबाद की पहचान रहा है। पर क्या है चार मीनार की असली कहानी, आइए देखिए हमारे साथ।
चार मीनार हैदराबाद की पहचान है, लेकिन बहुत कम लोगों को इसकी असली कहानी पता है। दरअसल इस इमारत के वजूद में आने के साथ ही हैदराबाद के निर्माण की कहानी शुरू होती है। हैदराबाद शहर 1591 में बना था। कुतुबशाही राजवंश की शुरुआत सन 1518 में हुई थी और गोलकोंडा उसकी राजधानी हुआ करती थी। समय के साथ साथ गोलकोंडा की आबादी इतनी बढ़ गई कि राजवंश के पांचवें शासक कुली कुतुब शाह को एक नया शहर हैदराबाद बनवाने का ख्याल आया।
The dynasty, the sultanate had reached the peak of its glory. There were a lot of affluence here. That prosperity attracts the masses, and there was a mass exodus into Hyderabad, into Golconda. Hyderabad was not as it there, which has resulted in the fortified town of Golconda being overpopulated, bursting at its seams. Hygiene was low, plague, pestilence was the order of the day, to the extent that even before Hyderabad was founded, we have people moving out of the Golconda fort. So there was a need to have a new city or an expansion of Golconda. Now, the resources that were there could not sustain a larger population by increasing the size of the city at Golconda. And it was, I think, logical that it should be a little away from this overpopulated section. So, the most logical route would be across the river on the southern bank of the Musi, on the historic road that went to Machilipatnam. Of course, a lot of things would have been explored, like the sources of water and all those things, and that is how they came to a conclusion that the spot where the city, the 5 mile triangular shape with a 5 mile base along the river was chosen, and that is where the city was laid out by Mamat Kuli. Qutub Shahis were basically Shi'i believers in Shi'ism. Ali, who is also known as Haider, is a very highly regarded figure in Islamic history, and this was named, that is the explanation given, that it was the city was named as the city of Haider.
Hyderabad शहर गोलकोंडा और मछलीपट्टनम के बीच बनाया गया। मछलीपट्टनम तब इलाके का सबसे महत्वपूर्ण बंदरगाह हुआ करता था। गोलकोंडा की भीड़भाड़ और घनी आबादी की वजह से ही शायद हैदराबाद को फूलों के शहर की तरफ बनाने की योजना बनाई गई।
And it was not a fortified city. The defenses for the city were minimal. It was more of a garden city, बागात. That is why in most of the instances in history, it is also referred to as Bagh Nagar, a city of gardens.
बागों के शहर के बीचों बीच चारमीनार है। चारमीनार की आकृति चौबारा की तरह है और इसके चार मीनार चारों दिशाओं की तरफ हैं। इसको लेकर कई कहानियां हैं, जिनमें से एक ये है कि इसे कुली कुतुब शाह और भागमती की मोहब्बत की याद में बनवाया गया था।
The first building that was constructed was the city center, the Chowbara, old Chowbara. You have Chowbaras in Bidar, you have Chowbara in Udgir, you have Chowbara in a lot of the city center or village center, square, town center. A structure marks the center of town. Charminar, no one knows why it was constructed. Again, there is a lot of controversy and debate regarding that. Some say it is to celebrate the love of Kuli for the Bhagmati. Some say it is thanksgiving for deliverance from plague. One, some say it is in the shape of a tazia. Basically, I think it's a glorified chaubara and nothing else. Of course, a lot of things are added. There's a madrasa on top, there's a mosque on top. All those things are there, but basically, it is a city center. And streets were laid out at right angles, emanating from the center of, if you take the Charminar as the center.
Charminar granite aur chune ke gaare se bana hai. Ye ek dilchasp imarat hai, kyunki ye na sirf chaubara hai, balki iski puri satah par ek masjid aur madarsa bhi hai. Charminar purane Hyderabad shahar ke madhya mein hai aur iske ird gird kai kutubshahi imarate thi.
To this north of the Charminar, you had the Char Kaman, the four arches, which enclosed what is called a jilukhana, a staging court with the fountain in the middle. And to the right of this staging court, you had the royal palaces, residences. The offices were now, where is now Lad Bazar, you had seven-storied, they say there was a seven-storied building called the Dad Mahal.
ये भी इत्तफाक ही है कि हैदराबाद और चारमीनार की नींव इस्लामिक कैलेंडर के हजारवें साल में पड़ी थी और इसलिए इसे सहशताब्दी का शहर भी कहा जाता है। चारमीनार का महत्व इसके इतिहास या बनावट और खूबसूरती में ही नहीं है बल्कि ये शहर के अतीत और वैभव की निशानी भी है। अलग अलग शासकों और सरकारें वक्त वक्त पर चारमीनार का इस्तेमाल अपने शासन को वैधता प्रदान करने और पहचान दिलाने के लिए करती रही हैं।
In the first decade of the 19th century, the Charminar appeared on the Hyderabad coinage. The first postage stamps of Hyderabad had the Charminar on it, and these were the Nizam's Hyderabad. So Nizam had already usurped, if you want to put it that way. I would put it as creating an identity based on claims of inheritance to Qutubshahi legacy, Bahmani legacy, and the legacy of the entire Deccan, and also Mughal legacy. So the coins, the silver and gold coins of, and of course the later the Copronical coins of course, were minted with the Charminar on one side. So that was linking yourself with as legitimate successors of the Deccan legacy.
और ये सिलसिला तेलंगाना राज्य के गठन तक जारी रहा।
People do not differentiate between the Mughals and the between the Nizams and the Qutubshahis. They considered it a continuous legacy. That is what was attempted, and that is where they succeeded by incorporating the Charminar on the coins. And again, when the Telangana state was formed, what you see on the monogram of the state, you know, emblem of the state, you have the Kakatiya arch and you have the Charminar. Architecture has always been a very powerful tool. And the two symbols which were chosen to represent Telangana, bring in the essence of Telangana, what were they? They were the Kakatiya arch and the Charminar, which again means that now the present day regime and the people of this region are linking their inheritance through the Nizam, Qutubshahis and the Kakatiyas. These are the three legacies which the present dispensation, political dispensation, is forwarding. Of course, public fervor is also by and large in that favor. People are united saying that these are the three important sources, the three regimes which contributed to fabricating or molding the cultural identity of Hyderabad in this region.
आज चार मीनार सहित कुतुब शाही स्मारक यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज की संभावित सूची में है। आशा की जाती है कि इन धरोहरों को स्थायी रूप से वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज का हिस्सा बनाने के लिए जल्द पहल शुरू होगी ताकि इन्हें नया जीवन मिल सके।
ये ताजुब की बात है कि 400 साल बाद भी हैदराबाद शहर में बनाई गई पहली इमारत चार मीनार आज भी उसकी पहचान है। अब हम आपसे लेते हैं विदा, और कहानियों के साथ फिर मुलाकात होगी।